like to know more about Anders. What was he like?
I don't know if there ever was just an Anders. He was crazy. By the end, there was nothing left in him except this insane need to start a war no one could win.
I heard you had family and friends in Kirkwall. Where are they now?
My sister's a Grey Warden. I had my friend Aveline take her as far from Orlais as possible. When all the Wardens started acting strangely, I had to keep my family safe. Isabella and I never believed in being tied down. When I had to go into hiding, she understood. We'll see each other again. Until then, she'll be having fun. And hopefully not too much fun.
Assume Varric's been feeding you information about the Inquisition. What did he say about me?
Only good things, I promise. I was a little surprised, actually. Varric isn't one for religion in general, but he thinks highly of the Inquisition. I think the exact phrase was, has a good shot at fixing Blondie's mess.
We'll talk later.
I'll meet you at Crestwood.
Scout Harding.
Your worship.
Shouldn't you be out there scouting?
In a bit. We're in Skyhold for supplies and a change of personnel. Not me, though. Indispensable.
So, who's Scout Harding, really?
Me? Oh, I'm no one. Lived near Redcliffe all my life. Herded sheep for my neighbor. When the Inquisition came through my village, I helped by telling them everything I knew about the area. Then I signed on. Wanted to see the world before it was swallowed up by that thing out there.
What's been going on?
Seeker Cassandra came through here, looking like a storm cloud. That's just her face, though, isn't it?
What's been going on?
Ambassador Montelier sent me a basket of flowers to thank me for my work with the Inquisition. She's so lovely.
What's been going on?
Varric came by to talk. He told me a story about copper marigolds.
What's been going on?
Madame de Fer said hello to me. Or maybe she was waving at someone else and I just thought she was. Yeah, that's probably what happened.
What's been going on?
That strange boy came in with an armful of chickens. You're looking after him, right?
What's been going on?
Dorian's awfully pretty, isn't he?
What's been going on?
Just relaxing, taking a breath. You need to sometimes to keep sane.
I have to go.
You knew where Hawk was all along.
You're damned right I did.
You conniving little shit!
You kidnapped me! You interrogated me! What did you expect?
Hey! Enough!
You're taking his side?
I said enough!
We needed someone to lead this Inquisition. First, Liliana and I searched for the hero of Ferelden, but he had vanished. Then we looked for Hawk, but he was gone too. We thought it all connected, but no. It was just you. You kept him from us.
The Inquisition has a leader.
Hawk would have been at the Conclave if anyone could have saved Most Holy...
Varric's not responsible for what happened at the Conclave.
I was protecting my friend!
Varric is a liar, Inquisitor. A snake. Even after the Conclave, when we needed Hawk most, Varric kept him secret.
He's with us now. We're on the same side.
We all know whose side you're on, Varric. It will never be the Inquisition's.
Attacking him now won't help us, Cassandra.
Ha! Exactly!
And you better not be keeping anything else from us.
I understand.
I must not think of what could have been. We have so much at stake. Go, Varric. Just go.
You know what I think? If Hawk had been at the temple, he'd be dead too. You people have done enough to him.
I believed him. He spun his story for me and I swallowed it. If I just explained what was at stake, if I just made him understand. But I didn't, did I? I didn't explain why we needed Hawk. I'm such a fool.
Good thing I still like you.
I'm serious.
You think I'm not?
I want you to know. I have no regrets. Maybe if we'd found Hawk or the hero of Ferelden, the Maker wouldn't have needed to send you. But he did. You're not what I'd pictured. But if I've learned anything, it's that I know less than nothing. Something is troubling me, Inquisitor. Leliana is receiving reports of mages becoming possessed, Templars going rogue. No one is dealing with these matters. I was hoping we might, before they get worse.
We can certainly look into it.
I will mark these incidents on the map as I learn of them, Inquisitor. And I would be pleased to accompany you if and when you investigate.
Do you have any advice for me?
Tell that demon, what does it call itself? Cole. Tell it to leave. He may not mean harm, but that does not mean he will not harm us. Spirits are not creatures to take at face value. Be cautious with him, Inquisitor.
Do you have any advice for me?
Watch the treasury carefully, with that Sarah present.
You think she's here to rob us?
Possibly not, but I would hardly put it past her.
Do you have any advice for me?
It's good that you recruited Enchanter Vivian into the Inquisition. She is ambitious, but has always shown sense in her dealings with the Chantry. My advice would be to watch her, but heed her when she speaks. That one wastes no words.
Do you have any advice for me?
You know what you need to do, Inquisitor.
That's enough for now.
Another time, then.
Haven was a cock-up, Herald, Inquisitor. But you did right by me, and others. We'll pay you back.
That got a little heated. You all right?
Well, that depends. How angry is Cassandra? I wasn't trying to keep secrets. I told the Inquisition everything that seemed important at the time.
I know, Varric. You never would have kept quiet otherwise.
I keep hoping none of this is real. Maybe it's all some bullshit from the Fade and it'll just disappear. I know I need to do better. I'm sorry.
Corypheus is back. Oh, shit.
You said he was a darkspawn or a magister. What is he really?
I'm not sure. I don't think Corypheus really knows either. He's definitely a darkspawn, but when we found him, it was pretty obvious he hadn't heard that. He thinks he's a magister, a priest of Dumat, in fact. He says he broke into the Golden City, like in the Chantry tale.
If you and Hawk defeated him once, we can do it again.
We didn't just think Corypheus was dead. He was dead. No pulse, no breath, full of stab wounds. There wasn't a lot of room for doubt. It makes me wonder. I thought the Wardens imprisoned Corypheus to use him. Maybe they did it because he can't be killed.
How did you and Hawk even wind up in a Grey Warden prison for ancient darkspawn?
Corypheus sent people after Hawk. He actually got control of an entire Carta clan. Made them drink darkspawn blood. Weird shit. We tracked the Carta to an old dwarven fort or something in the mountains. Of course, it turned out to be a trap. They needed Hawk's blood to open the locks holding Corypheus, and they drew us into the prison to get it.
There has to be a way to defeat Corypheus. We'll find it, don't worry.
I hope you're right. Maker's Breath, what have I let loose?
Brutally murdered is not really the same as unleashed upon the world, Varric.
In this case, it might be. But you've got more important things to do than listen to me worry. Just let me know when you want something shot.
Battling the demons of paperwork? That's a fight nobody walks away from clean.
You have no idea the number of times I've almost been killed by bills of lading. I've been meaning to come talk to you anyhow. I never officially joined the Inquisition. I don't know how to do this disciplehood thing. I'm a businessman. Never really followed a chosen one before.
I don't need a disciple. I need a friend.
If you knew how intimidating you are, you wouldn't make it sound so simple. You just don't know what you are to the people out there. The Herald of Andraste is a symbol bigger than any of us.
So what exactly am I to the people out there?
The sky tears open, demons everywhere. To ordinary folks, these are the end times. The only hope they have is you. You're the sign that somebody might hear their prayers. That maybe they're not abandoned after all. You heard the crowd singing after Haven was attacked?
Please tell me you aren't going to burst into song now.
Don't worry, I'm not that cruel. I should probably get back to work. Unless, you up for a game of Wicked Grace? I've got a minute if you need something.
I've read your Tale of the Champion, and I have a few questions.
That's a pretty common reaction. Go ahead. What can I do for you, Inquisitor?
What are your thoughts on the Inquisition?
You might want to keep an eye on Liliana. At this point, I think her secrets have secrets. Someone needs to get her out of the fortress for a while. Take a walk or something. She's starting to twitch.
What do you think of Liliana's work?
Do you want to know what the Arashak had for breakfast this morning? I think she can tell you.
What do you think of our general?
He needs more to do. Honestly, right now he spends all day cleaning his armor with a lost puppy look on his face.
How do you think Josephine is handling the job of ambassador?
If this Inquisition thing doesn't work out, I may hire her to deal with the Merchants Guild. She'd own them before breakfast.
Good to know.
Back to work, then.
What was this place? So much room for whatever was here.
Hello.
I'm interested in what you told me of yourself and your studies. If you have time, I'd like to hear more.
You continue to surprise me. All right, let us talk. Preferably somewhere more interesting than this.
Why here?
Haven is familiar. It will always be important to you.
We talked about that already.
I sat beside you while you slept, studying the anchor.
How long can it take to look at a mark on my hand?
A magical mark of unknown origin? Tied to a unique breach in the veil? Longer than you might think. I ran every test I could imagine, searched the Fade, yet found nothing. Cassandra suspected duplicity. She threatened to have me executed as an apostate if I didn't produce results.
Cassandra's like that with everyone.
Yes. You were never going to wake up? How could you? Mortal, the Fade. I was frustrated, frightened. The spirits I might have consulted had been driven away by the breach. Although I wished to help, I had no faith in Cassandra, or she in me. I was ready to flee.
The breach threatened the whole world. Where did you plan to go?
Someplace far away. Where I might research a way to repair the breach before its effects reached me. I never said it was a good plan. I told myself, one more attempt to seal the rifts. I tried and failed. No ordinary magic would affect them. I watched the rifts expand and grow, resigned myself to flee, and then... It seems you hold the key to our salvation. You had sealed it with a gesture. And right then, I felt the whole world change.
For all our sakes, I'm pleased that you stuck around.
As am I. You have fractured rules of man and nature, and you will shatter more before you are done. To visit me here, and you not even a mage.
What do you mean?
Where do you think we were?
This isn't real.
That's a matter of debate. Probably best discussed after you wake up.
They've certainly spared no expense.
Someone emptied a whole bag of turnips into the fire. Ah, Maker, the smell is
Honored, Inquisitor. Gotzi Sturhald. Did my part on the walls, and now I'm on this strange collection you've brought us. Don't know its worth to the fight, exactly, but it's good workmanship.
Where did you learn your skills?
Orzammar. Carved a few statues in my day. And before you ask, yes, I chose to leave. I carved a paragon who turned out to be a sodding madwoman. Couldn't stand looking at it. The memory of a dwarf, right?
Any ideas about the origins of these reliefs?
To Vinter, early. It's in the tool marks, the grain. That's hard dust mined from the Hundred Pillars, if I know anything. Oh, I suppose the scene is probably full of Tevinter robes, too.
The Hundred Pillars?
Damnedest things. Massive spires that aren't stone. It's like a mortar. Don't know more than that. Strong, though.
Do you have insight into the stories these tiles are supposed to depict?
Tell you what. You finish one, and I'll write it up. Who better, right? A good dwarven perspective.
Another time.
Best of the vein, Inquisitor.
Looking for someone to talk your ear off? I think I can oblige.
Can I ask you something, Varric?
You want to talk about me? I'm flattered. Also inclined toward extravagant lies.
Thanks, Varric.
No problem. Sleep well?
I've never done anything like that before. Do you regularly talk to people in dreams?
No. Consider that one more rule you have effortlessly broken in your rise to power. I had no idea that the Anchor would allow you to dream with such focus. It is truly remarkable. But I am reasonably certain we are awake now. And if you wish to discuss anything, I would enjoy talking.
I'd like to hear more about what you saw in your exploration of the Fade.
I would be happy to share it with you.
Tell me about the old memories you found in the Fade.
I saw a savage human horde go marching toward the battlefront. They sang a soldier's hymn to keep formation. Primal music shook the ground. These savage, unwashed warriors carried harmonies no chantry choir has mastered, though their cause was all but hopeless. They sang songs that made the spirits weep.
Tell me about a spirit you encountered.
I met a friendly spirit who observed the dreams of village girls as love first blossomed in their adolescence. With subtlety, she steered them all to village boys with gentle hearts, who would return their love with gentle kindness. The matchmaker, so I called her. That small village never knew its luck.
Tell me about the old ruins you explored.
I found the ruin of Barandur, a lost Tevinter city buried deep beneath a dead and barren wasteland. Volcanic ash had sealed it tight. In one dark moment, every living creature in the city seared and smothered. They were statues in the ashes, like a mold made to recall the lost.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
Something wrong with your tea?
It is tea. I detest this stuff. But this morning, I need to shake the dreams from my mind. I may also need a favor.
You just have to ask.
One of my oldest friends has been captured by mages, forced into slavery. I heard the cry for help as I slept.
I'd be happy to help. What did these mages use to capture your friend? Blood magic?
A summoning circle, I would imagine.
I'm sorry?
My friend is a spirit of wisdom. Unlike the spirits clamoring to enter our world through the rifts, it was dwelling quite happily in the Fade. It was summoned against its will, and wants my help to gain its freedom and return to the Fade.
I thought spirits wanted to find their way into this world.
Some do, certainly. Just as many Orlesian peasants wish they could journey to exotic Rivain. But not everyone wants to go to Rivain. My friend is an explorer, seeking lost wisdom and reflecting it. It would happily discuss philosophy with you, but it had no wish to come here physically.
Do you have any idea what the mages want with your friend?
No. It knows a great deal of lore and history, but a mage could learn that simply by speaking to it in the Fade. It is possible that they seek information it does not wish to give, and intend to torture it.
All right. Let's go get your friend.
Thank you. I got a sense of my friend's location before I awoke. I'll mark it on our map.
Isn't it? One moment you're trying to restore order in a world gone mad. That should be enough for anyone to handle, yes? Then, out of nowhere, an archdemon appears and kicks you in the head. What? You thought this would be easy? No, I was just hoping you wouldn't crush our village like an anthill. Sorry about that. Archdemons like to crush, you know. Can't be helped. Am I speaking too quickly for you?
You don't need to worry about me. I can keep up.
Yes, I noticed that.
Did you now?
Certainly. If you were a slack-jawed yokel, you'd already be dead. I always assumed the Elder One behind the Venatori was a magister. But this is something else completely. In Tevinter, they say the Chantry's tales of magisters starting the Blight are just that. Tales. But here we are. One of those very magisters, a darkspawn.
Who does the Imperium say started the Blight?
You know how it is. Not us. They say darkspawn were always there. Magisters and the Blight aren't even related. Is that a surprise? No one wants to admit they shit the bed. But if Corypheus is one of the magisters who entered the Black City and he's darkspawn, what other explanation is there?
We only know what Corypheus claims to be.
True. He might be a convincing liar, or delusional, or insane. But how many delusional maniacs are going to have that knowledge? He broke open the Fade. I knew what I was taught couldn't be the whole truth, but I assumed there had to be a kernel of it, somewhere. But no. It was us all along. We destroyed the world.
You didn't do anything. Those men did. 1,000 years ago.
True. Except that one of them is up and walking around right now. Not to mention I have idiot countrymen who would happily follow him down that path again. No one will thank me, whatever happens. No one will thank you either. You know that, yes?
That's not why I'm doing this.
I knew there was something clever about you. All I know is this. Corypheus needs to be stopped. Men like him ruined my homeland. I won't stand by and let him ruin the world. Oh, and congratulations on that whole leading the Inquisition thing, by the way.
Anything interesting?
A letter regarding Felix, Alexius's son. He went to the Magisterium, stood on the Senate floor and told them of you. A glowing testimonial, I'm informed. No news on the reaction, but everyone back home is talking. Felix always was as good as his word.
Was?
He's dead. The Blight caught up with him.
Are you all right?
He was ill, and thus on borrowed time anyhow.
That doesn't mean you can't regret his death.
I know. Felix used to sneak me treats from the kitchens when I was working late in his father's study. Don't get into trouble on my behalf, I'd tell him. I like trouble, he'd say. Tevinter could use more mages like him. Those who put the good of others above themselves.
With the two of you...
Felix and I? What an odd question. No, I had no intention of abusing Alexius's hospitality by seducing his son. Not that I'd been proper my whole life by any means. It wasn't like that. Even in illness, Felix was the best of us. With him around, you knew things could be better.
He should be an example for others to follow, or his death is wasted.
Should I spread the word? We could spawn the cult of Felix within a matter of days.
There are worse things.
Probably true. And you're right. His actions should not be forgotten. Thankfully, Felix wasn't the only decent sort kicking around Thedas.